What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Pokémon Emerald Nuzlocke. Last time we made it to Meteor Falls and actually went all the way through it and all the way back around, ended up in Rustboro City, and today we have to head back up Mount Chimney because Team Aqua and Magma are having a giant feud, and it ain't no family feud, it's more of a two evil organizations coming together. And we gotta stop them, because you don't want two evil organizations to ever come together in one place. It's not a good time, man. So we're gonna go stop them. Before, there were two Team Magma Grunts, I think, standing here. Now they're gone. So we can actually head on to one of my favorite little details of this game, and that is the cable car. It's ready to go up, so let's head on in. Look at this thing. It's just so peaceful and nice. I remember the first time I saw this. I guess it was in Ruby Sapphire. You don't see it in Emerald for the first time, but still, you know, we're playing Emeralds. It's the best of both worlds from Ruby and Sapphire, and I don't know why, the first time I ever saw that, it was just so nice and peaceful, and it brought a little tear to my eye, but I don't really tear up anymore. It's just like, I don't know, it just doesn't happen. It happened once, and I didn't really like how it felt, so I haven't cried anymore, you know what I mean? Anyway, this is Mount Chimney, I think. I just read this sign and it said Jagged Path, so I got kind of confused. But yeah, this is Mount Chimney. As you can see, Team Magma and Aqua are... Why do I always say that so weird? Magma and Aqua are fighting it out with their Poochyenas. But there's actually a couple of trainers here that we do get to battle. And oh my gosh, I just remembered that we're going to battle one of the bosses. Look at his Poochyena. It's going like three times the speed of all the other ones. What did you give this guy? Grr, Orange, I should have guessed you'd show up. See for yourself what the fanatics of Team Magma are up to. They're trying to inject the stolen meteorite's power into the volcano. Doing something like that will cause the volcano's eruption. Yeah, well, I don't know what to tell you about that, man. There it is, though. We are definitely standing on a live volcano right now. I don't know how old exactly we are, but I don't think we're old enough to be standing at the edges of volcanoes all on our own. But then again, the Pokemon Worlds is a strange and mysterious place where kids get to be kids, and they don't even have... What's the cereal that says that? Oh, it's Chuck E. Cheese, actually. It's not a cereal. For some reason, I thought it was like Frosted Flakes, where a kid can be a kid, but that doesn't really make sense, because how can you be a kid inside of cereal? That doesn't work, man. It's Chuck E. Cheese, where a kid can be a kid. I don't remember how it actually goes, but you know what? How about we ask these nice Team Magma Grunts? I'm sure they know what's going on, so give us a little bit of info. Tell us what's going down. Tell us how the life is up and when it comes down, you know? I have no idea what I'm saying. Today was a pretty exciting day for myself, though, because I went and got myself an Xbox One. And I haven't gotten any of the new consoles. I was debating whether to get a PS4 or an Xbox One, but honestly, no good games were coming out for like either of them. So today I finally decided to go and get myself an Xbox One because this game called Sunset Overdrive came out, made by Insomniac Games. And in case you guys don't know, a little history lesson about MunchingOrange here. My favorite video game company ever is actually Insomniac Games, because they made some of my favorite game series, which is Ratchet and Clank. They also made Spyro the Dragon, which I really liked when I was even younger than that. So yeah, they've made two of my favorite game series ever. And so they came out with a new game. They also did Resistance on PS3, but I didn't really like those. I also didn't really get a PS3 until maybe like a couple of years ago. So I never really, I played one of them and I didn't like it. So I don't know. It's really cool that they're making a new game, and it's more of a, not really a kid game, but they're going back to their roots with Ratchet and Clank. They have a bunch of weapons. You blow stuff up and it just looks really fun. So I got myself a Xbox One because it's an exclusive to that system. Kind of weird how they went from Sony to Microsoft. I guess that's just how things go, man. You know, you gotta go on the best console. Anyway, we're actually fighting a Team Magma admin, but shouldn't really be that tough of a battle. And Banzai should have this under control, so I won't worry about it. I'll just keep telling my story. And I know that we're gonna have to battle Maxi soon, so hopefully I can tell the story before we get to him. We have Rock Smash, so we should be able to handle this Poochyena. We'll see, man. I should actually be training up Eeyore, though, because the upcoming gym, we're definitely going to need Eeyore. And I don't know what level he evolves into Camerupt at, but if we could get him to be a Camerupt before then, that would actually be really helpful, and we would probably ace that Flannery's gym. But, as I was saying, got that, and I've been playing that all day, so it has definitely been really awesome. and pretty worthwhile so far. I don't know about any other games that are out on the system that I would really enjoy, so I was hoping that you guys could tell me. If you guys have an Xbox One, let me know what some of the cool games are for it that are... I mean, they don't have to be exclusives, but just games that I can get for it that are cool, because while I am really enjoying that one, obviously eventually I'm gonna run out of that. I have a lot of games kind of on this backlog that I keep of games that I want to beat, so I don't really need games for it. Oh my gosh, Eeyore, you beast! I love you! Thank you so much! Did you see that? I mean, I guess you guys saw that because, you know, you're watching this playthrough, so you probably saw that. But in case you watch this like a podcast, which some people do, I don't know actually if some people do that with my videos, but I know that sometimes I'll just watch Let's Plays like a podcast, which doesn't really make sense because it's a Let's Play, so you're kind of supposed to watch the game too, but I don't know. I'm weird, so I watch some Let's Plays like podcasts. If you do that, then either way, if you didn't see it, Eeyore just freaking destroyed another Numa Lair, and that was pretty rad. But yeah, let me know what cool games there are out there. I know that there are some really good upcoming games, but games that are out right now, if there are any, and you guys have an Xbox One, then let me know, because I don't know. So far, that's been the first one, and I'm really enjoying it. So now we have made it to Maxi, the leader of Team Magma. I definitely have to heal up my Pokemon here because I don't know exactly how this is going to go. I think Finch will be fine. Do we have like an Orange Berry or something that we can give him just to heal him up a little bit, but you know, not really overdo it. Actually, this Orange Berry will do just fine. Only restores 10 HP, but guess what? Finch didn't even need 10. So here we go. The power contained in the meteorite. By amplifying its power with this machine, Mountain Chimney's volcanic activity will instantly intensify. Its energy will grow deep inside the crater. And you, who are you? I'd heard Archie bemoaning a child who's been meddling in Team Aqua's affairs. It must be you, he meant. Huh, so you think you're interfering with us? Now you listen. Long ago, living things used to land and to live and grow. That is why land is all important. It is the cradle of all. That is why Team Magma is dedicated to the expansion of the landmass. It is for further advancement of humankind and Pokemon. And for that, we need the power of what sleeps within this mountain. Oh, there was no need for you to learn that much, but no matter. I'll teach you the consequences of meddling in our grand design. Hey man, I sure am meddling, but don't use that word, because that's for Scooby-Doo, and I don't have no Scooby-Doo. Oh god, we have Bonsai. Maybe Bonsai is secretly Scooby-Doo, and we actually are just the Scooby Gang, you know? Which ones of my Pokemon would be each of the Scooby Gang members? I'd say, you know, myself, I would probably be Shaggy. I mean, I could go for Freddy. I think his name was Fred. Was it Freddy or Fred? I don't know if it was Fred or Freddy. Let's see, Eeyore could actually be Shaggy. And then I guess that would leave me to be Velma, because who the heck else would I be? Nagini would definitely be the... I forgot their names. Daphne, I think, is her name. And I think that's it. So we probably just named our entire party. Of course, Banzai here. Bonsai, Banzai. I always change that name, too. It's like how I say Magma or Magma. I always say stuff weird, man. I don't know why. But we got the Mighty Enna against Mighty Enna action right now. And let's go for our Rock Smash. Absolutely no damage. So how about we don't do that? Let's actually just go to Finch and do this battle the easy way, because why the heck not, man? If you got an easy way out, just take it. That's what I like to say. Well, actually, don't always take the easy way out, because there's almost always going to be repercussions to taking the easy way out. It really depends on what you're doing, but, you know, in a Nuzlocke, if you got an easy way out, just do that, because you don't want to end up accidentally messing up and then you lose Pokemon, and then he uses a super potion, and it just makes your life all that much harder, man. Actually, Quick Attack might... Yeah, Quick Attack is doing, like, almost the same damage as Wing Attack right now, because I forgot that Finch has the Silk Scarf. But either way, there goes the Mighty Enna. Finch actually took a lot of damage from that, though, so not too great. Not really. Alright, next up is a Zubat. So let's go back into Bonsai. I don't really know exactly what to do. If it comes down to it, though, we will definitely send out Kung Pao. He's kind of just been sitting there. I haven't really been using Kung Pao that often, but he's just for right now sitting in the reserve, just waiting for his moment to shine. And I think that might come during Flannery's gym, because I have a feeling that it's going to be pretty tough. So far, I mean, Roxanne and Brawly were pretty easy, but then again, they're kind of part of the tutorial area. I like to consider it at least. So, okay. We can probably survive one more hit from this Zubat. So just please, break through. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Alright, let's just hope we can survive the swing attack, because otherwise I was going to be pretty upset there. Yes, sir, indeedy. That would have been pretty sad. Alright, well, you know what? It worked out in the end. My heart skipped a beat, but that seems to happen pretty often here. Banzai lives another day. And of course, Maxi's final Pokemon. Not looking forward to this, because it is Camerupt. But I have prepared a special treat for this guy. I don't really know what to call it, but it is Eeyore. And we are going to go for our special attack. I probably should have taught Eeyore Dig. That probably would have been better. But you know what? We've got the Magnitude. And we're going to try and get Magnitude 10. Oh my god, we got the Magnitude 10. Are you serious? Oh my gosh. Eeyore, you are a beast. Eeyore, you are a beast. I love you. Eeyore, I love you, man. Holy crap. We did it, boys. What? That is exactly my reaction, Maxi. Yeah. I mean, I think I was also caught off guard, so just in your defense there, man.
But enough! I will back off this time, but don't think that this is the last you've seen of Team Magma. Foo 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 foo! Even without the meteorite, if we obtain that orb, foo 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 foo.
Archie, was he even walking there? It felt like he was just hovering, but he was like making really tiny steps.
Thank you! With your help, we thwarted Team Magma's destructive plan. But you, whose side are you on? Aye, it doesn't matter. We will return vigilante.
I can't read. I seriously can't. But yeah, he has a weird walk. It's like, he almost looks like he's hovering. A meteorite is fitted on a mysterious machine. Let's take it. Why the heck not, man? I don't know what this meteorite does, but I always forget to get it. So this time around, we're gonna get it. And actually, it's a key item. I thought it might be a held item, but never mind. It's just a meteorite found at Meteor Falls. I have no idea what you use that for. But I should definitely use up our TMs because I've been forgetting that we have these. So Eeyore, you are finally gonna learn Dig. I know it's been a while, buddy. You've been waiting for it, but now you've earned it. So we're gonna get rid of that growl and we're gonna give you something a little bit more powerful here. Dig. Gosh, Banzai got pretty dang low from that, didn't he? Can anyone learn Rock Tomb? We actually have three that can learn Rock Tomb, but I'm not really using up Mei right now. I don't even know if I want Mei to be on our team. Like, if we have the choice later on, Mei probably won't stick around when we catch another new Pokemon. Steelwing, also kind of worth it to give this to Finch. At least, I hope Finch survives long enough to get utility out of this. I actually shouldn't waste a TM because you never know what is going to happen. And in this game, TMs are not reusable, in case you guys didn't know. But yeah, they introduced that, I think in Black and White was the first games that had reusable TMs. But that is not the end of this episode. We may have taken on Team Aqua, or taken down Team Magma, but we still got more to do because we got high out Volcanoes. Now the floor is so lava, but we have to head down the mountain, and I'm just quoting lyrics, but there's not really much reference to it aside from the fact that there's lava. Cookies! Yeah, you can buy cookies from Grandma here. It would be awesome if she had the option to buy like a dozen of these because lava cookies are actually very helpful and super cost efficient at only 200 Poke dollars. You can get yourself basically a full heal, which would normally cost you, I think, way more than that. I'm not really sure exactly how much it would cost you, but we're going to go down to 59,000 Poke Yen. It's not really 69,000, so there's not much of a joke to it, but you know, whatever, man. Lava cookies are great, so buy as many of them as you can. Actually, don't, because it's a huge waste of money to just use up all of your money, but buy as many as you want, man. However many you feel comfortable having. I bought some cookies from the supermarket the other day, and they sucked. So if these lava cookies end up sucking, then don't blame me. Blame Grandma. That did not even heal us up all the way, but whatever, man. We're just trying to heal up because we have got another route to take on in this episode, and that is the Jagged Pass, Mount Gymnast Jagged Pass. Now, this is what I've always wanted in a mountain. This jagged bumpiness, it rocks my soul. Rocks your soul, man? Are you going to have some rock-type Pokemon? I wonder, oh me, oh my, what kind of Pokemon will the hiker have? How about a Geodude? How about a Baltoy? That doesn't matter. Banzai is going to eat all of them up. For breakfast, for dinner, for lunch. I don't really Do people, like, I don't know, do you guys have all of your meals? Because usually I have, like, 2 meals a day. I don't think ever since I, like, whoa, okay, I forgot what you got. We got a new Pokemon, and it is going to be Machop. So let me focus up for a second and try to catch this guy here because, this Machop might not be bad because we definitely need a fighting Pokemon for not Flannery's gym exactly, but the next gym, our dad Norman's gym, is going to be normal type. Excuse me, but we're a fighting type would come in pretty handy there. Machop is kind of hard to train though, especially to get to his last evolution, because of course we got to trade to get Machoke, and I don't know exactly if I can even get a chance to trade in this game. Like, I don't know how I would like do it at all, so don't know if it would be that great. I should also switch out because I'm about to get critted by a Karate Chop and die. So Finch, you get out here and tank the damage while we toss some more Great Balls. Hopefully we can catch this guy soon, because he'd be really good to have on the team. At least for that gym. So, I don't know if I'll keep him forever, but our new team member is going to be Machop. Got no idea what nickname I want for him, but, you know, as a little bit of backup for Kung Pao. Oh my gosh, I just realized we have Kung Pao. Our dad's gym is not going to be as tough as I thought, with Kung Pao at least. I say that, and I probably just jinxed it, like I always do, but what should we name this guy? What should we name it? He's a big buff guy. What are some big buff guys I know? Okay, I got it. Zangief, because that's a tough guy that I know, sort of. He's in a game, so I don't really know him. But we're going to name him Zangief, because that is what he's going to bring to our dad Norman. Grief, after we beat him and take his badge. It's a pretty clever name, right, guys? I would probably have to say so. I'm complimenting myself on my lame Pokemon nicknames. We have stooped down to a new low, and I don't even know what the word stoop means, so that's how low we are, man. I really don't know. But what I was saying earlier, going back to that before I forget, ever since I started going to high school, I would say, not that I'm going to high school still, but when I started going to high school, I since then, basically, I don't think I've ever had like my 3 meals a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I usually have 2 meals, either like, I don't know, I always eat breakfast, but hey, what am I doing in a place like this? I didn't even know we had to battle this guy, but I mean, it's probably kind of a pushover here. So ever since then, I either have, I guess, like breakfast and then just skip to dinner. I never had lunch, or I'll have breakfast and then lunch, but then never have dinner. I don't know why. It's just like, that's the way that it's happened ever since high school. I guess because I would have a big breakfast, and then at school they would have a big lunch, so I wouldn't really be hungry when it came down to dinner time. Either that, or I would be super hungry at dinner, so then, because I didn't have lunch. But I would almost always have breakfast, you know, the most important meal of the day, serving it up Gary's way. Except I'm not Gary. Yeah. I just wanted to show off that you can go on these. I don't know why, there's really no point to come up here, but just the fact that it's cool to show off that you can do that, because look, you have to have the bunny hopping bike, and if you stand right in the center, you look really awkward. It's like, am I mid-jump? Like, what's happening here? I think it is supposed to be like your mid-jump, but I don't know, they couldn't figure out a proper way to do it. What the heck? You can run into wild Pokemon while bunny hopping? I did not even know that. Really? That's pretty cool. Huh. Well, anyway, gonna bunny hop right past that guy. I'm actually gonna heal up Bonsai again because don't want him to die. You know what I should do, though, is actually put Eeyore up first and have him gain some levels. Because Bonsai, you are definitely caught up, buddy. You know what? We will give this EXP share to no one. Eeyore, you're gonna get solo experience for a little bit, man. Hey, never mind, it's a double battle. Climb this hill every day. I have confidence in my strength. What about you? Ah, yeah, this is awfully scary to shoot down the mountain in one go. I'm guessing you must have an Acro bike. Acro, why do I say weird, like, words in this game weirdly? This is like the first time even that that happens, because I don't usually say things in a different way than just the standard way to say things. Like, I don't know, man, that's really strange. Magma, Aqua, Acro, what else? There's another word that I say weird. I don't know, I guess you could say Pokemon, because you can say Pokemon so many different ways. What way do you guys say Pokemon? You know what, I'll save that one for the next one, because there are so many ways you can say Pokemon, it's kind of ridiculous. Alright, last trainer here in the Jagged Pass. It's a hard to walk on, but it's a good place for training. Well, actually, It is kind of hard to walk on. I'm on a bike, so I wouldn't really know. But man, oh man, let me tell you, it is pretty dang fun to get on your acro bike and hoppy scoppity away. Oh, we burned him. That means that even with your focus energy, even if you got that crit, doesn't matter, man. You ain't gonna win when you're burned, son. Camper Ethan, I don't want your number. Just a little bit too young for me, man. You know, I like to hang out with the older kids. That's just the way it works. Gotta hang out with the older kids. Hey, we actually made it. I thought we were miles away from Lava Ridge still. I thought there was a whole nother route, but I guess I am imagining things or confusing this with Fall Arbor. So here we are, Lava Ridge Town, home of the fourth gym. So next time, we will be taking on Flannery, the leader with a fiery passion that burns. But before that, there is actually a little item that is over here before I forget, and that is a nugget. Don't know if that's really worth it because now we have to go all the way back around, but that gives me an excuse to go back on my favorite little thingy feature. I don't know what to call this really. It's just like, it's nice, man. You just sit here, watch a little cutscene. You know, they weren't that in-depthless cutscenes back in the day, but oh, look at that. I used to think that was snow, but then I realized that's probably the ash coming off the volcano. So, I don't know. Maybe I got snow on my mind because it's so freaking cold here. This place is weird, man. I swear, it was like 80 degrees yesterday, and today was like almost 30. So I don't know what's up with this place. But now that we've made it back to Lava Ridge Town, I will see you all next time. So if you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.